Hi, I'm Casey. I'm an information science professor. And one of my areas of research is technology ethics. And in recent years, I've been thinking a lot about how we teach ethics, especially to computer science students. So this video is an overview of how I think about ethics in computer science education. I'm also going to talk about a few research studies that have come from myself and my collaborators, and most notably, a paper that is published at the ACM Conference on Computer Science Education, SIGCSE, this year, 2021. So first, let's talk about ethics in computing. Hardly a day passes without some new controversy about ethics in the tech industry, right? Sometimes I joke that being a tech ethics researcher just means making slides that look like this over and over again until I retire. Much of my research has involved deep diving into controversies like these, especially with respect to understanding the reactions of the general public. If you're interested in learning more about these, I'll link down in the description below to some papers that I've written specifically about things like data sharing controversies, the Facebook emotional contagion study, and also if you like this video, you should definitely watch this entire video essay that I have about Zoom bombing and how I think it suggests ways that we should think about ethical design for technology. But take, for example, the Cambridge Analytica scandal. Now, it's unlikely you haven't heard of that at all, but as a very short reminder, data from millions of Facebook users was used without their consent to create models that could be used to micro-target political advertisements for Facebook users. In the wake of that scandal, a former Google engineer wrote this great op-ed where there was a line that really resonated with me. Software engineers continue to treat safety and ethics as specialties rather than the foundation of all design. And I thought, yes, yes, that's exactly it. But why is this the case? Why do technologists so often treat ethics as a specialty rather than something that should be part of everything we do? And my theory is that this has to do in part with how we often teach ethics in computing education. So I wrote an entire op-ed about this at the time that I would love for you to read. But as you can see from my pithy tagline, I think that if you work in technology and you don't think about ethics, you're bad at your job. Or rather, this is what I think the attitude should be. This is what I would like to see the cultural shift move towards. And let me put this another way, using a metaphor. On a construction site, there is someone whose job it is to be a safety engineer. It's something you train to do, to be a specialist in safety. But that doesn't mean that the person putting up the drywall sees a live wire and thinks, oh, that's the safety engineer's job to worry about. You have to at least know enough to recognize a problem, care about it, and then seek further expertise when it's needed. In the mid-90s, the National Science Foundation funded a task force to figure out how we should teach ethics and social impact in computer science. They pointed to two approaches. One, required standalone ethics classes for CS majors, and two, integrating ethics into every class. But if you could only do one of those things, the latter is preferable. They wrote an article for Communications of the ACM in which they argued for this 10th strand in computing education. And in response, there was a letter to the editor written by a computer science professor. This is an excerpt. In it, they argued that this proposed subject matter isn't computer scientists, that they couldn't imagine a computer science instructor teaching these things, and that, even though it might be important, discussing the social and ethical impacts of computing is not doing computer science. I disagree. I think that this is doing computer science. And I think the fact that so many people think it isn't doing computer science is the problem. Even though this letter was written 2 decades ago, I still hear the same kind of argument, mostly from people on Twitter. And I still constantly hear from students who say that they're not learning anything about ethics at all. If we want to get towards ethics being part of the foundation of all design, we need to start teaching it that way. In the United States, in order for a computer science program to be accredited by ABET, they have to provide students with, let me make sure I'm reading this verbatim, an understanding of professional, ethical, legal, security, and social issues and responsibilities, and an ability to analyze the local and global impact of computing on individuals, organizations, and society. Now, how these things are actually accomplished varies widely. But despite this requirement, I hear frequently from computer science majors that they're not getting this as part of their curriculum, that they don't hear about ethics, even students who are in extremely prestigious programs. Of course, sometimes even if they do, a really common model for this is a required computer science ethics class that often comes towards the end of your degree program. I taught one of these classes when I was a PhD student in a computer science department. It was a really great class. However, I definitely had the feeling that for some students, they just spent the last 3 years learning how to be computer scientists, and then suddenly, right at the very end, right before you graduate, oh, here's something that you should have been thinking about all along. What about a different approach? What if you are thinking about it all along, in every class? Right now, this is not a common approach. A few years ago, myself and some collaborators analyzed a set of artificial intelligence, machine learning, and data science classes taught at the top computer science undergraduate programs in the United States. And with a very generous definition, we coded for whether their course descriptions or syllabi, when available, mentioned anything that could be broadly construed as ethics, social impact, privacy, etc. Though there were also a number of standalone classes, for example, AI ethics, only 12% of the technical classes had anything like this mentioned. Now, it's entirely possible that these topics did come up, especially in the classes where we didn't have syllabi. However, we at least know that it wasn't important enough to be in the course description. And anecdotally, this is what I've heard from a lot of students who have taken classes like this, that maybe they get some of this content in a different class, but that ethics is not part of their technical classes in things like AI and machine learning. And these are some of the topics where ethics should be the most relevant of a lot of different things one can study in computer science. So now I want to lay out a case for ethics integration, and in every computing class. First, it emphasizes ethics as part of technical practice. It's not a specialization or an add-on. It's not just for the safety engineer. I often hear an argument along the lines of, well, product development teams just need to hire philosophers, which, like, great, I am very here for more jobs for philosophers. And it's great to have specialists. But in addition to those specialists, everyone needs to be thinking about it. Everyone needs to be able to recognize that live wire, know why it's a problem, and then talk to the safety engineer if they need to. And also to not take the regular wire and strip it down on purpose. Why that would be a bad thing. So not everyone needs to be a total expert on ethics, but you do need to know some, and you need to be thinking about it. This means that when you take a machine learning class, it should be emphasized that if you are not learning how to understand the bias in your training data, if you're not learning about the social implications of classification, if you haven't considered how that classifier might be used, you have done a bad job building that classifier. that those things are an essential part of the process, which means you need to learn them as part of the process, not in a class that you take 2 years later. And that's the second problem, which is that teaching ethics siloed divorces it from its context. You need to get the lesson at the right time. It needs to be contextualized into the thing that you're learning to do. And finally, the third really big benefit of integration is that it ensures that everyone who takes a technical class is exposed to this content. A lot of people take a CS class or two, but don't major in it. I mean, some of the most famous tech CEOs out of there dropped out of college before they finished their degree, maybe before they got to their required ethics class. But you can do a lot of damage with a little bit of code. And so for that reason, anyone who learns to do anything in computing needs to learn that thinking about ethics is part of that. And so, especially with this in mind, we piloted a program to integrate ethics into introductory programming classes. This was funded by the Responsible Computer Science Challenge, which I will talk about a bit at the end. We started with intro programming because it has the benefits both of reaching a large number of students who may not go on to take further computing classes, and it emphasizes, even for computer science majors, that ethics is an integral part of computer science from the very first class that you take. And we did this in three different classes in the computer science and information science department. They were for a mixture of majors and non-majors, these different classes. Now, there are a lot of different approaches that we could have taken with this, but we decided to start with the one that would be the least amount of work for the instructors, who are often overburdened with very large classes and limited time to do assessment and to rework material. So what we did was we took assignments that already existed in these classes and we recontextualized them so that they were teaching the same technical concepts, but were recontextualized to inherently bring up ethical issues and current ethical dilemmas in tech. So you can go to this website to find copies of these assignments, and we're continuing to put together more material, videos, slide decks, etc., to help people who might want to use these. So depending on when you're watching this video, there might be more or less there. But as a preview, here are some brief descriptions of the two assignments that we used in this pilot study. The first one was about personalized ads. The technical concepts that it covered were conditionals and Booleans, essentially if-then statements. The student was put in a position of writing an algorithm that would determine what ads were being served to a user on a social networking platform. For example, if the user has a dog, advertise dog food to them. Very simple. And then there were some more complicated aspects to this, including determining whether they might be an introvert or an extrovert, depending on the number of friends that they had, and then serving them a certain kind of ad, or using information about zip code to proxy for income, and using that to determine how ads were served. So this assignment was designed to emphasize how someone's data on a social media platform might be used to determine advertisement, how inferences can be drawn from data even if you don't explicitly tell a social media platform something about yourself, and how information about you can determine not only what is advertised to you, but how it is advertised to you. And this tees up a conversation about ethical controversies like Cambridge Analytica. The second assignment was about college admissions algorithms, which I think is a great example because many people are taking intro programming classes as freshmen, and this is a very fresh, important context for them. And so this assignment covered technical concepts like iterating through a list and doing mathematical transformations and reading and writing to a file. They were provided with lists of student data that included things like GPA, SAT score, a demonstrated interest score, The assignment asked students to write a function that would create an overall score for each student that could then be used to have cutoffs for admission into the university. But importantly, the assignment walked them through additional kinds of transformations that could identify certain kinds of outliers. For example, what if a student has a zero demonstrated interest score because they don't use social media or don't have a home computer where they could constantly open emails from that university? What if a student had one bad semester that pulled down their GPA? So they wrote functions that look for outliers in the data, and then we had a discussion about the kinds of decisions that algorithms should or should not make, the kinds of false positives and false negatives they might have, and how this could impact things like students who are admitted into college. In the paper published at SIGCSE, we report on a lightweight evaluation, as well as the perceived benefits and challenges of this approach from the instructors and teaching assistants in the class. But overall, we feel like this was really promising and that it went well. We also hope that you'll check out our materials if you're interested in using some of this yourself. And there's also a lot of other great resources, and on our website we have linked to things from other people as well. In particular, I'd like to point you to some assignments that have been shared by Evan Peck, a computer science professor at Bucknell University. He also does ethics-based assignments in an intro programming class. And I love these about the trolley problem using MIT's moral machine experiment and job hiring algorithms. Another benefit of intro programming in the context of integrating ethics is that a lot of people learn to code before they get to college. One of the things we're hoping to do next is translate what we're doing into the K-12 space. And if you are in the K-12 space, you might be interested in this AI ethics curriculum for middle schoolers that comes out of a project at MIT. I also maintain a crowdsourced spreadsheet of tech ethics syllabi that are openly available. There's 250 by now. We also have a paper where we analyze these syllabi. And so if you're wondering, what do you even teach if you want to teach tech ethics? This gives you the answer. And if you're teaching a technical class, it might give you ideas for the kinds of topics that you could integrate into that class. And I am so happy about all the work that's being done on ethics integration, particularly just in the last couple of years. A lot of this is because of the Responsible Computer Science Challenge, which is funded by Mozilla, Omidyar Network, Craig Newmark Philanthropies, and Schmidt Futures. Thanks to this challenge, as this work wraps up, we're going to see a lot more open resources to help everyone else do this kind of thing. I will link down below to some more information about that. I would also like to add that one of the reasons why this is so important is not just because computer scientists have a lot of power and therefore a lot of responsibility, but also because if we love this field, then it needs to be the best that it possibly can be. If you haven't seen it, I would like to point you to this Communications of the ACM article written by Amy Koh and collaborators, which makes an argument for more critical CS education. I spend so much of my time thinking about the harms of technology and what we can do about that, but the reason is because I think it's so amazing. And I think that if our students are going to go out and build the technologies of the future, then we need to give them all of the tools that we possibly can to make sure that they are making the world better through what they're doing. And I think that rethinking the role of ethics, responsibility, and justice in computing education is the right path forward. This is one of my favorite topics, so feel free to reach out to learn more. And I'm Casey. Thanks for watching.